Once in Vijayanagar, it kept raining continuously for several days, due to which people were very upset.
Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Para Brahma.
Oh no! What's this? What are you doing?
Prayer to the God for stopping the rain.
You spilled my dress on.
Not only Raju, but also others in Vijayanagar wanted the rain to stop. Among them was Chaini Prasad, the sculptor of Vijayanagar. Where could he find the stones to sculpt statues in the rain? So he began sculpting the stones he had at home.
Wow!
Oh, where did my stone go? It was here somewhere. Huh? Where is the stone? Move away from there, please.
Oh, what happened, my dear?
Have you seen my stone that I used to grind the chutney?
How do I know?
What? You made a statue of this too? Now how do I grind the chutney? Where are you running away?
Whether it was Raju's prayer or Chaini Prasad's patience, the rain stopped and the open sky of Vijayanagar was narrating the story of the havoc caused by the rain. When Raju left for the temple to thank God for stopping the rain, he saw something by the riverbank that he had never seen before.
Miracle! Oh God! After helping us overcome the troubles in Vijayanagar, you yourself came to bless us. We are blessed! I'll tell this to everyone!
Oh no! Not this! Not even this! Not a single stone is of use to me! Oh God! This is injustice!
God has come! God has come!
Our justice has been served quickly, God! This flat stone is perfect for sculpting a statue. It will be a lot of fun. I'll bring my chisel and hammer right away.
In the same stone where Raju saw God, in that very stone, Chaini Prasad thought it would be perfect to sculpt a statue. But this was not going to stop here.
I'm very tired now. You go and take some rest too, huh? Wow, such a flat stone. Why not take some rest on it? Oh, it seems I fell asleep. And why not? This place is so nice, and on top of that, this stone is so flat. This place will relieve all the tiredness of my business friends too. I'll inform them right away.
Hey, wait! I say wait! Let me carve the statue first. Then we will fill it with colors.
This is not color. It's turmeric and vermilion. How sinful you are. God himself has appeared. And you can't see it?
But how can he appear until I carve the stone with my chisel and hammer?
Stop! Leave!
My friends, go and fight somewhere else. We just want to relax, yeah? What is the problem with you? Huh?
Bhaskar, it's me, Pannu.
Oh, so you did all this. How dare you sit on my god?
This is a stone for sculpting, not a court.
Don't you try to come in between this.
This stone is for making sculptures.
No, this is my god.
This is my stone.
No, it's mine.
No, it's mine.
It is neither yours nor yours. It is mine.
Stop there! Arjun, who are they?
They look like tribals. We are soldiers of King Vidyadhar. Move back.
We need to clear this stone blocking the path.
I'll see how you move my god from here.
This is my stone for sculpting. If I complain to the king, you will be in big trouble.
We are also merchants. Don't try to threaten us by using king's name. Go and make your statue somewhere else. This is for our relaxation.
This is my stone, understood?
Hey, Keshav! Why are you washing clothes on our god?
But where is your god?
Look, this is our resting and relaxing place. Move away from here.
What relaxation? This stone is for making sculptures. Statue? Resting place? God? This is my stone for washing clothes.
What?
The mud might have stuck to it due to the rain. That's probably why there's a misunderstanding among all of you.
He's talking as if his name is written on it.
Oh, yes. Yes. What? Have you seen it now? Now go from here. I have to wash the clothes of the royal palace.
So Keshav reached there and washed away all the desires of those people, isn't it?
Wow, Amma, what an interesting story. Everyone had their own perspective regarding that stone.
Absolutely right. And what was the outcome in the end?
It was a washerman stone.
Udanka and Chenilal, two swindler traders living in a village near Vijayanagar, were preparing to sell their goods at the trade fair in Vijayanagar.
Here are the wild leaves.
Here is my dirty cotton. And on top of that, good quality wool.
With the wild leaves, here are some good quality leaves.
Where, my friend? Trade fair? To be frank, what are you taking there to sell?
This time I am taking such a bitter leaf that as soon as you put it in your mouth, it will feel like a breath of fresh air, money's honey. Try this.
Wow, it's sweet.
By the way, what do you have in your sack?
Oh, don't ask, my friend, don't ask. To be frank, it's such a thing that if it reaches the market, the whole market will heat up.
What is it?
Rare wool of the sheep from the high mountains, which I have filled in these sacks myself by climbing those high mountains, to be frank. Just understand this much. If I put it on you, you will start sweating immediately and can fill four pots with your sweat.
Four pots of sweat?
Because of the betel leaf was more expensive, Chenu gave Udanka an extra coin.
This is called profit! Oh no! What is this? Cotton? A little bit of wool on top, the rest is all dirty cotton. I thought I had fooled him, but he also... But no problem. This cotton is better than those wild leaves. And on top of that, I got this coin.
No! Just a few betel leaves. The rest are wild leaves. He cheated a cheater. I will not leave him. Udanka, I am coming to take back my coin. Rookie trader, to be frank, come out.
When I'm already outside, how much more outside will you throw me? Money is honey.
You liar, you have shown your true colors just like the betel leaf, which looks different from the outside but tastes like something else. I want my coin back right now.
Just your coin? For whom am I pulling this mud out of the well? Just for you. For whom am I digging the ancestral treasure buried inside? Just for you. If you help me with this, half of the treasure will be yours.
Are you again playing some tricks on me?
No, I swear on the betel leaf's money is honey.
Oh, what? A treasure! I'm in! Treasure! Where is the treasure? Treasure! Treasure! Oh no, I'm exhausted. I hope he hasn't fooled me again. To be frank, I should leave from here. Let me teach him a lesson. I found it! I found the treasure!
What? Did he find it? I had staged all this drama to fool him, but he actually found some treasure, money, honey.
Pull up! Oh, put some more effort.
This seems right.
Here comes the treasure. And the one who was going to claim a share in the treasure is forever trapped inside the well.
Money is honey.
You, where is the treasure?
Did you cheat me? Money is honey.
Someone who gave wild leaves instead of betel leaves is calling me a cheater. I will come back to take my coin. If I don't get back my coin by tomorrow evening, the consequences will be very bad.
But Chenu was not among those who accept defeat easily.
Today I won't spare Udanka. You cheater, come out!
Chenu has arrived!
You remember what to do, right?
Where did he go?
Who has dared to enter my house? Thief!
I'm not a thief, I'm Chenu. I have come to take my coin back.
He came from outside and laid down to rest.
enough drama. Now get ready to see my drama. How did this happen, my friend Udanka?
What has happened to him?
Huh?
Sister, looking at him, I can't believe it. I think it's not too late yet, my sister. We need to take him to the doctor immediately.
Wait, listen to me. Don't take him.
Why is he taking me towards the jungle?
What was that? I feel very scared in the jungle at night.
So, what should we do? Should we go to the city and get arrested by the soldiers?
Soldiers are better than ghosts. Because soldiers might punish and let us go, but not a ghost. Wait, I'm also coming.
Are you feeling good now? Wake up, you cheetah! Your drama is not going to work anymore.
He's talking about waking up the ghost.
If you don't get up on your own, I have other ways.
What is he going to do?
Enjoy your journey to the ditch.
Stop! Stop it! Somebody please stop it!
The ghost woke up!
Run, ghost!
Run? Now the camel has come under the mountain.
Wow! We have indeed found the real treasure! This is your share, and this is mine. And here is your coin.
And this way, both happily went back to their homes.
Wow, Amma! This story was really interesting. Thank you, Amma.
Today, I must say thank you to my children because due to your drama, you got the opportunity to hear a story from me. And I got the ending to my own story. Once in Vijayanagar, a resident named Babban fell so ill that all the money in the house was spent on his treatment. Now there was only one cow left in the house, which could be sold to arrange for Babban's medicine. Babban and Nirmala decided to sell the cow. Babban's wife Nirmala was a simple woman. When the discussion of selling the cow in the market came up, Babban explained everything to her before sending her.
Listen, don't talk to anyone on the way. Just do your work and come back home directly.
Namaste, auntie. Huh? Auntie didn't even respond to the greeting? That's strange.
Seems like we have got something good today. But why is it moving? Oh no, catch it!
I thought we would find diamonds and jewels. But what did we find? This sheep?
Now watch how I turn this sheep into a cow.
Just like Nirmala had a cow, Mungi had a plan to take the cow from her.
My cow?
What happened, auntie?
I brought a cow. This ship is not mine.
This sheep is indeed your cow. You might not know, but there is magic in the air here. As soon as the air passed through it, the cow turned into a sheep.
What? Magic in the air? Huh? You never told me before.
See, Auntie, this is my donkey. Huh? Mm-hmm. It turned into a human with this magical air, but it hasn't become intelligent yet.
What has happened?
Chungi Mungi, who turned the cow into a sheep, now turned that sheep into a chicken.
Huh? Oh no, magical air again.
It wasn't the magic of air, but the magic of Chungi Mungi's hands.
Who will buy this old rope now? Even the air seems upset today.
After hearing everything from Nirmala, Babban understood that the two boys had fooled her with the story of magical air. And the very next day...
Did you bring Mangloo's rabbits? But will they be able to complete your plan? Be careful. There shouldn't be any more losses.
Keep watching, Nirmala. But do you remember what you have to do?
Yes, I remember.
Yesterday we made good money without any hard work.
But here, Chungi and Mungi didn't know that today they were going to receive a big shock.
Slowly, my child, slowly.
A rabbit?
These must be the same two whom Nirmala had talked about.
Wow, Uncle, this rabbit is so cute. Where are you taking it?
This is not just a rabbit, but my heart too. I'm ill. That is why I'm going to sell him. He listens to everything I say.
Everything?
Yes. He plays with me. When I grab his ears like this, he likes it. Then I lift it with one hand and spin it around. Like this, like that. Like this way and that way.
No, but how can a rabbit be a piece of someone's heart?
Tell him to.
Not like that. Give me proof. Only then I will believe that he listens to you.
Why not? My child Chiku, go and tell your auntie to prepare potato curry, kheer and puri also. Huh? I am coming with guest, okay? Are you listening? We have arrived.
Yes, Chiku informed me. I have prepared potato curry, puris and kheer.
It's true. This rabbit turned out to be very clever.
Here you go, Uncle. Now this rabbit is ours.
As I told you, he is a piece of my heart. You cannot buy him with such a small amount.
Okay, Uncle, take this too.
No, my child, no. It won't be enough. This is a wonder of the world. If I didn't need coins, I would never sell him. I'll take him to a big market and sell him there.
If we take this rabbit Chiku to the palace and sell it to the king, then we won't have to steal for the rest of our lives. We'll play with the coins instead of stealing them.
Okay, take this too.
Not enough.
Take this too. That too.
Take this.
Take out more, Chungi.
I don't have more.
Take everything.
All right. That's enough.
Why did you invest all of your earnings in this rabbit?
Because this rabbit seems to be smarter than you. I'm pretty sure about my investments and also about the money. Now, keep watching how the money comes back.
Huh?
Chiku, go and tell Uncle that if he doesn't bring the money within an hour, we will come and loot everything.
Several hours passed. Neither Chiku came nor did Babban show up with the coins. That's when they suspected that Babban had fooled them.
Uncle, come outside!
What happened, my child? Did you forget something?
Don't act clever, Uncle. We want our coins back.
Why not? Here they are.
These are stones.
But there were coins in it. It seems like the magical air turned them into stones.
Is there such a magical wind?
Yes, there is, isn't it? Like a cow turns into a sheep by the magical wind.
And the sheep into a chicken.
Oh no, she's the same auntie, the cow owner. The one we had robbed.
The soldiers haven't gone far. Should I call them?
They made a fool out of us.
Now go from here. We need to rest.
No, our coins!
Soapy, there is no magic in the air. Check once. It's possible that the coconut didn't go up in the air, but may have fell into your bag.
Oh, yes! Found it!
If you like this video, subscribe to our channel, Murthy Media.